Hi, I just bought this Philips micro music system. Exact model is TAM8905/10. Before I bought this, I found only one short video on YouTube as a review. So I decided to make my own review. Maybe someone will find this useful. Why I chose this particular model? Because my search criteria was output power and Bluetooth. And this particular model provides 100 watts RMS of output power. And also as a bonus I get a smart radio, like internet radio and digital radio, USB, CD, and this small interesting color LCD. I don't know what kind of information it shows, like if it provides RDS information or not. Let's open the box and find out. So, accessories. We got a power cable. I don't know why it's the UK. We got remote control. We got a European power cable. Nice. And this seems to be a power cable for speakers. Okay. Let's put this aside. Small manual, batteries, Philips. This looks like to be antenna. Quick start guide. Wow. Speaker. Nice. Okay. Oh, this is a shield for speaker. Okay. Two shields. The second speaker and the main unit. Main unit. Nice. Okay, I will connect everything, check out, and then do a second video. Second take. The battery for remote is inside. That's okay. Now about connection. Real man does not read instructions. Okay, there is everything very simple. Here goes antenna, speaker terminals and power. About speaker terminals, you just unscrew this and put your cable in. Cable already come soldered, and with this heat shrinking tube, just put it inside and screw on. I like screw on terminals better than those spring loaded terminals. But the screws are plastic. Okay, now the speaker side. Speaker side looks like this. Unscrew the terminal. It's look like cheap plastic. Expensive ones come with the metal ones. There is this hole. You put the wire into the hole and screw the terminal. And that's it. Speaker is connected. Okay. Now it's the left speaker, and then we'll proceed to the testing the unit. Okay. Okay. We have connected our speakers and are ready to go. This is screen. When the unit is not powered on, it shows time and data. Let's power it on. And it's immediately ready to go. And going to the last source position. The easiest way to get all features is to press the source button, and now you can see all possible features like internet radio. Let's select that, and it's connecting. Oh yes, we already have gone through the initial setup where we choose our access point, Wi-Fi, and provided our password, Wi-Fi password, and choose the way how to synchronize time. Okay. And you can see it's now playing internet radio, Retro FM Latvia. It's even showing the logo of Retro FM. We can easily select another station from the list. There is a lot of lists, like from Latvia or Popular or anything. Let's select Latvia and local stations, and doesn't matter, 5 FM, like this 5 FM. Okay, it's connecting and and playing. Okay, let's go back to the sources. We have a podcast, it's also internet shows, Spotify. Everyone know what the Spotify is? DAB Plus, a digital radio. Unfortunately, we here in Latvia does not have a DAB Plus coverage. Government run 2 stations for approximately 2 years, but it comes to the no decision. They decided that it's not rentable to run DAB here in Latvia, so no DAB Plus in here. Sorry. FM radio, conventional FM radio. Okay. Surprisingly, FM radio have RDS information, like this studio number, SMS, short message, and WhatsApp number. That's cool, because specification in the internet shop where I ordered this unit stated that RDS is not available, but actually it is available and it's working fine. Going next is CD. It's opening only when I selected source of CD. No problem with that. I don't have any CD currently with me. So moving forward, USB. Select that. I have a USB stick formatted as FAT32. It does not accept NTFS. Let's plug it in. Which one? MP3's music track. Loading, and my track is already playing. I can like turn it louder. Cool. Yes, I can say that this radio is really powerful, and for 20 square meters room, it's more than enough. I can like turn it louder. Okay, moving forward. Bluetooth audio. Select that. I have my passport here. And let's turn it on. Let's select Bluetooth. And Bluetooth is enabled. This music center is listed as Philips TAM8. Oops, let's go back to the, where was it? Oh, sorry. Bluetooth. It's already connected. Okay. And now just play some. Maybe this one could be fine. Yes, it's old phone, but I like it. BlackBerry Passport. Play. Okay. And I'm playing Avicii. And you can see the information on the LCD also. Avicii, Lonely Together. Yes. Nice. Nice beat. Okay, moving forward. We have audio input. Unfortunately, we have only one audio input here. Not at the back. I don't like it because I would like to connect this unit to my computer as speakers, but I don't like dangling cables in front of it. Okay. Okay, and that's it. That's all the features of this of this radio. The FM can be tuned easy with the left knob, and the volume is the right knob. Here you can power switch, IR LED. Okay, let's tune to 7.2. And some control buttons for like next track, previous track, stop, play, menu, list and sources. And this is a favorite button. That's it. That's all the features of this micro audio system. I like it. I can show you how the speaker looks without the shield. It's like that, beautiful red, yellow bass speaker and the small tweeter. Nice. Okay, thanks for watching. I hope someone will find this useful to decide whether to buy it or not. I can say that it's the output power is really powerful, and the rest of the features works fine. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.